like. This should be free.
All right, so with the bottom removed, we're gonna look at hull damage. Now this, oh my goodness. Whew, that's terrible. Same for this corner. Just munched. And the side. All right, so I'm going to go over with you how to make a skirt. Now, there's no wrong way or right way to do this. And technically, it becomes much easier because I already have one made, so that would easily make a pattern. But I'm just going to do it from scratch again so I can show you how to come up with one. And you can use different materials, and if you do, the only issue is how you seam them together. It might be different in the way that I do it with this, but the basic principles are the same if you're needing to make a skirt for your hovercraft project. Now, my typical approach to this is I build the hull first and then make the skirt, right? Which is, it seems like that's the logical way to go. So what I'm going to do, what you need to figure out first is how far past the edge do you want it to come. So I think on that one it's right about 4 inches. Grab my tape measure. Okay. Yep, 4 inches. Okay. So grab the hole. And actually, one of the first things I'm going to do is get rid of that strip right there that's got all the eyelids in it. We also need to remove the edges that have those suction cup things stuck to them, so I'll cut that edge off. Alright, so here's the first skirt section ready to be cut out. Now, the edges there are just a sharp square edge. I need to round them. And so what I'll do is I'll take like a roll of tape, something that gives me a nice curved edge, and then I'll round off the corners. But what I did up here to get this looking like it does, you take a tape measure, two hands here, you take a tape measure, and in my case it's 6 inches because I wanted 4 inches of stick out past the edge of this surface, and then you need an additional 2 inches to seam it. So what I do is I take two, like this. This is two pieces of material. It's the same pieces, it's just one's cut out on top and one's cut out for the bottom. But then you see here, and I actually just did an inch on this one. I'm gonna go, I'll go up to two on that one. I may actually trim it and go an inch seam, or I may increase the skirt size one more inch on each side and just seam it at right at an inch. But anyway, that's how I end up with the curve and these lines here. And so now we're going to cut this out. All right, so that's the first one of those cut out. For a single layer like this skirt originally was, you would need two of these shapes. But I'm going to cut out three this time. All right, we have our three pieces of material cut out. And now the next step before we start joining these together and doing anything else is we need to take one of them and cut a small hole in the center, obviously where it will be cut out later, like on that one, for example. But for now, just cut a hole big enough to get your arm in. In case you need to work the inside. Eventually how this works is you'll cut out the hole for the top and then you turn this thing inside out after you seam it. So I'll cut a small hole in there and then we'll get started sticking it together. So now that we have our hole, we're going to start by taping the edges. So I have 2.8 inch wide, or I forgot how many millimeters that was, 70 something. So anyway, it's not quite 4 inches, right? Because I added 2 inches around the edges to account for the seams. So it looks like this skirt might be slightly wider than the old one once we're all said and done, but that's okay. So what you're going to do is you're going to peel a strip of tape to grab the longest, flattest edge that you can, and you're going to put exactly half of the tape width on the top, and then you're going to fold it around and put exactly half of the width on the bottom. So alright, we take my skirt seaming tool, clamp, and slowly drag along the tape. You have to use paper or tape or something, otherwise it'll just melt the, I think this is PVA or something, but it'll melt the plastic and stick to the hair straightener and make a huge mess. Originally I did this using just pieces of paper and that worked, but the paper wouldn't come back off. However, I've discovered that at least with this masking tape, it will peel off. And just for extra reassurance, because I want a really good seal, I'm going to run over this twice. Alright, so to do the curve, I put tape on one side. I didn't like tape them together, but I put tape on one side where it overhung slightly, and then I flipped it over and cut off the excess, you know, where it was past that edge. And then I did the same thing to the other side. And now, boy, hopefully that's not too thin there. And now I can go through and do this. And what I did on here was I figured out what my depth was, and I should have done this first, but I put a piece of tape on here. So as I go around, I know what my depth stop needs to be. I think that needs a little bit better yet. So, all right, here we go. There was one area that I had to go back and do over because so I'm just pushing my finger right into the seam to see if it starts to separate. And if it does, then I know that's exactly where I need to go back and reclamp. I'm just gonna take a piece of tape. The layers together is initially when you're trying to stretch the material out and make sure that you have even sides all the way around.
Remember, the more even and uniform you can make the corners, the better the performance of the skirt. Okay, quick recap here. I've got the center cut out. We're done laminating the edges. I didn't really cover how I did that, so what I did was I had made a couple of small alignment marks where the hovercraft sat. I didn't actually draw the outline because sometimes that's going to change, you know, if you screw up or something when you're putting it together. So I just used tiny alignment marks, set it on here, made sure that it was square still, and once I was satisfied, I picked it up, and then I took my masking tape that's this width, and I ran tape all the way around here. You could also mark, you know, a second line, but that gave me the line I needed for the cutout. So now this is cut out, and now we flip it inside out. Because actually the whole time we have been working on this inside out. Sometimes, if you flip it inside out and you have weird edges or edges that don't want to cooperate because you have an inch of crap hanging around inside here, you can cut that and trim it up so it's thinner. I try to avoid doing that as much as possible because I feel like the more bonding surface area you have for the lamination, the better your odds are. Yeah, it seems like it's gonna go okay. We are almost ready for glue. Cool. So that's basically how that's going to work. And now I have to figure out something new, because with this particular skirt design, we have made more than one revision. So not only do we have two layers of bottom material, I got something else. So let me pop this back out. Oh, and before I go down that path, out of curiosity, how close did it come to this one? All right, so my prediction was right. It'd be about an inch bigger on each side. Cool.
The gluing process has commenced. Now, contact cement is not really compatible with shower curtains. If you spread it against an edge, the edge curls. And so I've put masking tape around the edge on the top side, and I'm working it around and getting it all glued in place right now. This is a pain in the butt, and it takes a while, so I'm just going to slowly work through this, and I haven't cut anything out on the bottom yet, so I'm waiting until the top is glued in place, and then we'll flip it over and cut out the bottom.
try it with the holes uncovered.